Hello students, my name is Sejal and today we are starting with our chapter number 2, India's Foreign Policy. In the last chapter, we learned the meaning of foreign policy and the factors that affect it. In this chapter, we are going to study the background and the features of India's foreign policy. Let us understand the background. India's foreign policy has been influenced by the idea of peace. Mahatma Gandhi, children, is a symbol of peace and tolerance which come from our ancient history. The Indian culture teaches us that the whole world is like a family. Vasudev Kutumbakam. This is also expressed through our foreign policy. The principle of international peace and understanding which emerged from India's freedom struggle have also influenced our foreign policy. On the 15th of August 1947, India got her independence. As an independent nation, it was necessary for India to decide on her own foreign policy. However, the broad outline of the foreign policy had been decided in the pre-independence period itself. Let us see what were they. Opposition to colonialism. What is colonialism, children? It means capturing other countries and making it a colony. Why opposition to colonialism? Because India was a victim of it for a long time. Cooperation with peace-loving nations. Opposition to any distinction on the basis of race or color. Supporting the freedom struggle in the other countries. Striving to establish world peace. As a head of the interim government, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru had given a speech on 7 September 1946 in which he had clearly stated the objective of India's foreign policy. Interim means temporary. He stressed on the need to formulate an independent foreign policy, not falling prey to the pressures of the other nations. Formulate means to make, whereas prey means victim. Constitutional provisions. After gaining independence, India started formulating her own independent foreign policy. The basic objectives of our foreign policy is to protect the independence of the nation and to preserve our territorial integrity. Territorial integrity means safeguarding our borders. Article 51 of Directive Principles of the Constitution of India guides us how we should conduct our international affairs and transactions. The article states the principle of our foreign policy. They are to promote international peace and security. Second is to maintain just and honorable relations between nations, to foster respect for international law, to encourage the resolving of international issues peacefully through tribunals, means court of law.